Action. Okay. So we're on 39. 2 log 3. Any ideas?
Right. 3 x squared.
I wrote that right. Yeah, you can move this up as x squared, but there's probably an easier way, and that would work. Yeah, you could just divide by 2. It does work both ways, but I don't want to take the time to do it both ways. Well, actually, on this one, since there's a log on this side, I actually might have to go the other way with it. Okay, so we'll go with the first suggestion. We'll move the 2 right there. Yeah, it's not going to work very well if we, because of the log thing on both sides, log being on both sides. It's kind of a mess. Alright, now what can we do? Well, if they're both of these logs are equal, then these two things have to be equal. X squared has to equal 25. Remember that trick? And you have logs on both sides. You can't take square root up here because not all of this is squared. Just the x is squared, and that's part of the log. So anyway.
Plus or minus
5. On this one, I think this might have came up once, but we should check and make sure both of these actually work. That's the easiest way to check, probably. So here's the problem. If I plugged in negative 5 right here, it'd be like 3 to the what equals negative 5. What could you multiply 3 by to get a negative? Or how many times could you multiply 3 to get a negative? I guess it would be like a question. Doesn't really make sense. Doesn't really work. So anyway, the negative on this doesn't really work. So it's just 5. That would be true on every case unless your base was negative, but we haven't done any negative bases, so basically just throw out the negative answers on these. Alright, number 41. 2 log of x equals 6. This one looks much easier. What do you guys think? Divide by 2 will be easy. It's because there's no log over here, so when we divide by 2, let's get a 3. So log of x equals 3. Now what?
Divide log?
No. This is not log times x, this is log of x. Anyway, basically, we had two tricks on these kinds of problems. We had them both the logs are equal, and we just set those two things equal. And the other thing is we change it, and we did this a lot, we change it to exponential form. If the x is right here, that's basically what you're going to be doing. So, what's this as an exponential equation? What's our base?
10
to the what?
To the third equals x.
So, what's 10 to the third?
$10,000?
No.
That's right. Yeah, you're right.
Okay. Okay, 43 log base 6 of 2x minus 4. Any ideas for a good for first step on this one?
Path forward.
Yep.
How do I know that the minus 4 isn't part of this log thing?
No parentheses.
Not in parentheses. Just the 2x. It's log base 6 of 2x, whatever that is, minus 4. So I can get rid of the minus 4 by adding 4.
Change it to exponential form.
Which would be?
6 to the third equals 2x.
6 to the third is 216. So 216 divided by 2. Five to the 4x equals 18. What's different about this problem?
It's already an exponential form.
It's an exponential form, so what are we probably going to have to do?
Change it into a logarithmic
form. Right, change it into logarithmic form. So what would it be in logarithm form?
Log 2 to the 8 equals 4.
Log base 2 of
18.
Equals 4x. And how do I solve that?
Divide by 4?
Well, eventually, but what do I do first?
Log of 18 over log of 2.
You can do log of 18 divided by log of 2, or if your calculator has it, you can plug it in like this. And your last step will be divide by 4. So one way you can plug it in your calculator, this might be the easiest way, be that this. You could also use the natural log, it doesn't really matter if you use this trick, I mean. It doesn't matter what base you use.
How would you know not to change it into an exponential form?
It started out in exponential form. So we changed it to log. Number, the first one we didn't have to change an exponential form because it was just two of the same logs equaled each other, so we just made that stuff inside equal each other. So the first one we did looked something like, it was something like this. So if you get something like this, you just make 4x equals 28. But if it's just like a normal log, like then you set up as an exponential equation.
Okay.
So, yeah. So there's like one trick for this, another trick for these, and then the third kind of problem is where it's already an exponential equation, you gotta turn it into a log or something. Alright. Number, so did you, on 45, did you round it to the third decimal place? What'd you guys get?
Wait, what the hell?
Yeah, 1.042, yes. 47 looks like pretty much, 47, 6 to the 4x equals 30 to the 3x plus 1. The problem on this one is that both sides have a variable in the exponent, and that kind of causes issues. So if we tried to set it up as a log function, like we did on the last one, it'd be log base 6 of this big thingy equals 4x. I see what I did there. That's still kind of a mess because we still got a variable up here. So I'm not going to do that. What I'm going to do is take the log of both sides. This is a tough one. If these two things are equal, then the log of these two things should be equal. And this is gonna help me get those variables out of the exponents, basically. Now that they're both logs, that means I can take this 4x and move it down. I can take this, move it down. Distributive property. It's gross. Divide by log of 6. That's not helpful. 4x.
Maybe we should just stop at 45. 47.
Is this the giant one we did on the other day? The other week? Show what they did. Jerks. And 49's easy again. Distributive property. This was the one that kind of like the one I turned into bonus the other day. And we did one of the odds, it took us like 5 or 10 minutes. And then, anyway, yeah, let's skip it. That's too much. It takes like 10 lines. But 48 and 49 go back to easy. So it looks like only 47 is like that. Well, I said easy, I mean, yeah. Regular, we'll call it regular. All right, so 49, 2 times e to the x equals 7. What do you guys think for this one?
Divide by 2.
Divide by 2 is a good idea. It'd be log base E, but what's that also called? Natural log of 7/2 equals X, right? So how do we solve for X? Just plug in natural log of 7/2 or 3.5. Just change it to a log function right off the bat.
And then what's the next step here?
Well, you get log base 3 of 32 equals x plus 9. So you gotta figure out what log of base 3 of 32 is and then subtract 9. Okay, on number 50, last one. A newspaper publisher forecasts that its 20,000 subscribers will expand by 5%. Each year, how many subscribers are there after 3 years or 10 years? Oh, wait, that's an even. Okay. Get started on it at least. So, if something's growing 5% every year, how do we do that? There's a formula. And we need to have these two formulas memorized for the test. By the way. You guys know what I'm talking about?
The prices thing.
Yeah. This is called the exponential formula. It's also used for simple interest, but when something increases by 3% a year or 4% a year, that's the percentage it increases by, that's the time, how many years, you know. And also we need to know the compound interest. This one is pretty much just used for money. Although you wouldn't have to use it for just money. Yeah. I'll probably make that like number one. Like write those down and then if you get it wrong, I'll fix it so you can use it on the problems. Alright, so if it's just, you know, something increasing by a percent every year, it's just this simpler formula that they're asking for in 50. So, starts with 20,000 subscribers expanding by 5% every year. So, 20,000 subscribers, it's an initial amount, plus 5%, what should we change 5% into?
0.05.
Right, so you could write 1 plus 0.05, or you could just write 1.05 to the t, and then the t is 3 years is their first question, and then 10 years is their second question. So you should have two answers on that. We're talking about subscribers, people, so you should round it to the nearest person.